The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus went up to the mountain to pray, and he spent the night in prayer to God. When the day came, he called his disciples to himself, and from them he chose 12, whom he also named apostles: Simon, whom he named Peter, and his brother Andrew; James, John, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Thomas, James, the son of Zebedeus, Simon, who was called the Zealot, and Judas, the son of James, and Judas Iscariot, who became a traitor. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We continue to feed on the thoughts of God, because the best food for our soul is not ideas nor things about other persons or even events. The best food for our soul is the thoughts of God. That's why we relish, we feed on the Word of God. We feed on God. That's the food of the soul. Today we will reflect on one of the three attributes of God, namely omnipresence, omniscience, omnipotence. The three attributes of God. God is present everywhere. Omniscience. God knows everything. Omnipotence. God is powerful. He can do what he wishes. There's nothing impossible for God, except things that are non-God, meaning to say sin. God cannot commit sin because it's non-God. Everything is possible for God as long as he wants it. If he does not want it, he will not make it possible. That's why we will convince God to want it. And you know what God wants? Our holiness, our salvation. So today we focus on the omnipresence of God. Omnipresence. The attributes of the divine essence, little bit philosophical, theological, are omnipresence, omniscience, omnipotence. Omni meaning all, covers all, totality. Omnipresence. That means God is always present. God's words to Moses, "I am who am." Exodus 3 verse 14. It expresses his eternity. He did not say, "I was." That means he has the past. Or, "I will be." That means he's not yet perfect. He will be perfected in the future. God is always present. Compared to us, we have our past, we will have our future, and we are now at the present moment. But for God, everything is present. And therefore, he is eternal, eternal present. God never began to exist. There was never a time when God did not exist. So it's not true that man created God. No, it was God who created man. Because some atheists say that it was man who created God, who projected his desires and created somebody to fulfill that desire, and that somebody is God. So man created God. He invented God. No, the Bible tell us God created man. Before he created the world, he is already. He exists already. He existed before the world, as a builder must exist before the house that he builds, and the watchmaker before the watch that he fashions. God can never cease to live as men do. Hence he is called the living God. That's Matthew 16, verse 16. And God is immortal. 1 Timothy 1:17. He existed before all time, and he will exist to all eternity. With him, there is no past or future. All is present with him. The whole history of the world is and has ever been in his sight. There is for him no succession of events. For him, there is no time. He is beyond time. In 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 8, it says, one day is with the Lord 1,000 years, and 1,000 years as one day. So God is always present. So in terms of time, omnipresence, he is present, not past, not future. He is always present. I am who am. In time, in relation to space, he is also present. He is in every place. After Jacob had seen in the open country the ladder reaching up to heaven, he exclaimed, God is in this place, and I knew it not. Genesis chapter 27, verse 16. The same words are true of every place. God is not only present everywhere with his power, but he himself fills and penetrates all space. In the book of Jeremiah 23:24, it says, do not I fill heaven and earth, said the Lord. So God is everywhere present. Why? Because he created things, and all things exist in God. All creatures exist in God, as thought exists in our minds. As mind is of more extent than thought, so God is of more extent than the world and all it contains. As mind penetrates thought, so God penetrates the world. In Acts chapter 17, verse 8, in him we live and move and have our being. So God is present everywhere because he sustains the world. Kung maghalin ang Diyos, kagbayaan sang Diyos, matunaw, matumba, kalibutan, wala sa nag-sustain, nagahang siya, wala sa nag-sustain, sina mahulog siya, ma-destroy siya. That's why amo nang hambal ni Jesus, I am the foundation of the world. Ti ang tao hindi magkilala sina, iban, Sabi niya silang foundation of the world. Hindi ganit sila katindog kung magmasakit, a foundation of the world pa. Kasalig lang ganit sila sa bulong. Tapos mapahambog pa na ako ang haligi. Hindi ganit katindog sa imo ko galing, ikaw pang haligi. Kung ikaw ang haligi, tanan-tanan, ipusdak sa imong bugat, kaya mo. Ikaw haligi, haligi ka. It's not true. Haligi ka, kay gatungtong ka sa isa kadako ang haligi. Kay may nag-sustain sa imo. Hindi ka magpahambog, oras ganing akwaon sang Dios, ang iya power, dira. Kagang iya strength, matumba ka. Hindi ka ka-sustain sina. Ara ka dira, gina-sustain ka sang Dios. Pasalamat ka. Hindi mo siya pag-i-reject. Buhi ka subong adlaw. Kaya ginalaw sang Dios nga imo kalag ara pa sa lawas mo. Kung kuwaon niya ng kalag mo, na ka na mahimo. That's why in Him we live and move and have our being. Acts 17:28. So present ang Diyos sa time, all the time. Present man ang Diyos sa space, everywhere. Pero may special presence siya in the Blessed Sacrament, special na yung presence nabutang sa aton catechism. God is present in a special manner in heaven, in the Blessed Sacrament, and in the souls of the just. So maghambal ka mo. Din si Father Junik, ara sa ano? Ara sa sukumbento? Ara da sa simbahan? Ari ako sa simbahan. Pero kung kaisa, ara ako sa kusina kay Dada. Ang akon special presence sa kusina. Pero I am also here. I'm around. I'm present. Kaysa ara man ko sa opisina, ang special presence mo. But I am here. Pero may particular space na ginapili ang Diyos para sa iya special presence. Heaven, of course. Blessed Sacrament, heaven sa babaw. Diri sa kalibutan, Blessed Sacrament. Blessed Sacrament, present siya. That's why kung gusto niyo mag-istorya sa iya, go to the church. Adoration Chapel, sarado pa subong, kay may COVID. He's present in a special way. Real, real presence. But sacramental. Sa langit siya, real and personal. Face to face. Diriya, real, pero mediated. Mediated sa ano? Bread. Tago siya sa bread. For the same incarnate God. Present makuno siya sa atong souls. Pero ang iya present sa souls naton, sa grace, sa sanctifying grace, sa Holy Spirit, present siya sa atong soul. So God is everywhere, but especially in heaven, His throne, especially in the Blessed Sacrament, in the church, and especially in the soul of a Christian through the Holy Spirit. There is no place where God is not. That's why no one can hide himself from God. So ano kuno ang aton response sa presence ng Dios? We must continually bear in mind that God is always present with us. That means we remember His presence, and that remembrance gives strength in times of temptation and holds us back from sin. Kung present, kung aware ka permisang presence ng Diyos, hadlok ka gawa maghimo sa la. Hadlok ka mangawat. Sa hindi ka makita, may nagkatanaw sa imo. Mabuhinan gawa ng imo sa la. Do sa'y nagadamo ang sala, kay damo ang naga-ignore sa God's presence. Pero kung ibalik naton ang presence of God and awareness and remembrance of His presence, mabuhinan ang sala. Di nagahalin ang sala. Wala ginarecognize ang tao nga may presence ang Diyos. Now, sa simbahan, butang mo imubag sa likod. Kuwaon sang iban, kawaton nila. Simbahan na na. Kaya hindi siya aware sang God's presence. O aware man siya, gina-ignore ya. O, isa ka babae, kita na sila sa ilang miga, nag-chismisanay sila. Wala, bira-bira sila chismis. Wala sila kabalo ang gina-chismis nila, gabati sa likod. Pagbati nila, nahuya sila nga duha. Ah, aragaling gina-chismis nila. Naguntat sila. Siling isang gina-chismis nila. Nasigihan nyo, chismis. Sigihan nyo, nga naguntat ka mo. Naguntat sila. Kaya may presence ang ilang gina-chismis. That's why kung present ang gina-chismis mo, lumahuya ka man mag-chismis. The same with God. Kung real presence, kaya na-recognize mo, nahuya ka man maghimo sa la. Probably mo kung wala siya, hapos maghimo sa la. That's why sakto ning catechism, niya ang omnipresence ang Diyos, nagapabuhin sa ngaton sa la. Hadlok kita maghimo sa la. Holds us back from sin and strengthen us in times of temptation. That's why, Father, ano ang pinaka-best nga antidote sa temptation? God's presence. Be aware of God's presence. Nya ti Father, anong nami nga para mag-behave kami sa simbahan, nga maghambal, magsunod kami sa imo? God's presence. Recognize that God is present. Mabehave ka. Hindi sa akon, kundi sa God's presence. So, galuhod ka, o ga-communion ka nga tinlo kamot. Nga ginagawagasan mo kamot mo antes mag-communion. Because you believe, nga ginareceive mo Diyos. Kung wala ka ga-believe sinayam, saan ano lang nang himuon mo. Kasi importante ang God's presence, recognition of God's presence. Balik na ito na, labi naging sa simbahan, Blessed Sacrament. Kaglabi naging sa soul sa isa katao, image and likeness of God. The remembrance of the presence of God increases our zeal in God's service. So nagapainit pagiganos ang aton nga pagserbisyo sa Dios, and leads us to practice virtues. Gusto naton mag-grow sa virtues. Kag mag-perform sang aton mga duties in a more careful way because of God's presence. O magsimba ka bala, isa wala ga-recognize nga may Dios, ang isa ga tipos ka mo. Ari sila. Pero ang iban ra recognize, why na daya? Nagakaon, naga-cellphone, wala sang God's presence. Tapos tanawab lang misa nga wala God's presence. Presence lang sang tao. Ti istorya ka dai. May presence ang Diyos. Tidiri kay mo ga istorya. Lain gid ya. That's why kung mabalik ang presence ang Diyos, experience of presence of Diyos sa simbahan, lain ang focus. Communion, God's presence. O sermon, lain ang imuya focus. Hindi God's presence. Ano to karon ng imuya? Kung ano imuya ginapang-analyze? God's presence. Nice mo ya kun ay hala kiwi tong bayo ni Father, eh ano man ang imo ya, ang amo ng imo di amo na God's presence. Ya kun ano man tong hambal ya, sala man to, di amo na. kulang sa recognition of God's presence. So kung gusto mong mag-grow, grow in the presence of God. Focus. Dira ka mag-grow. The nearer the water is to the spring, the purer it is. The nearer one is to the fire, the greater the warmth. The closer we keep to God, the greater our perfection. Ito ka nami. Kagara ang Diyos sa iya presence, di kita pagbayaan, hambal ni David. Though I walk in the valley of darkness, I fear no evil, for you are with me. Oh, nag-iisog ka man gali. Kung konbensido ka sa God's presence. Muna natabo kay David, though I walk in the valley of darkness, I fear no evil, for you are with me. Ban nga makabataan ko, nahadlok ko yung multo ko, no? Pangadi kabla kay Jesus, God's presence, madula na. Proteksyonan niya ka, baptized ka, hindi ka magpadaog, upod mo siya. O, gaisog sila. Gaisog ka ginman, basta aware ka permis ang God's presence. And lastly, God is present, that means he does not change at all. Ang nag-change kita. Di Father, nag-change ang Diyos sa pagtawo ni Jesus? No, wala siya nag-change. Kita nag-change. Humanity has changed. Ang adlaw wala ga-change. Ang ga-change, effect ya. Kung maigo ya ang candle, gatunaw. Pero kung maigo ya ang mud, nagatiga. Tiyan mo man ang Diyos. Kung maigo ya ang santos, gatunaw siya, ga-contrition. Pero maigo yang makasasala nga wala contrition, gatiga tagay pusoon. Lain-lain nga effects. So depende kung anong imo disposition. Kay amo nang imo matchi, amo nang ga-change sa imo, not God. That's why para sa iba ng Diyos, friend. Para sa iba ng Diyos, enemy. Pero pareho nga Diyos. Lain lang ang oh, pang-espiho ko kay ina. Wala ga kambyo espiho, ako ni tsura ga kambyo. Ala, may ano naman ko. May punggod naman ko. Wala yung kambyo espiho. Ako yung kambyo. The same sa Diyos. Wala yung kambyo ang Diyos. Ang kambyo kita. Permanente ang Diyos. Good. Permanent good. Pero ikaw, depende sa disposition mo. Response mo sa Diyos. So God does not change. He's perfect. Kitang nag-change. That's why dapat mag-change kita after Him. Model naton sila. Friend naton ng Diyos. And therefore, para sa nagapabilin sa sala, ang Diyos, kaladlukan, pero sa nagapabilin sa grasya, ang Diyos, amay. So ay depende kung anong disposition. Police, kung kriminal ka, lagan ka. Pag wala ka man nahimo, nga madlok ka. The same sa Diyos. Ang reaksyon sa tao, lalain-lain, depende sa tao, disposition, not depende sa ga-change ang Diyos. No, wala ga-change. The same siya. Because He is present in time and in space, and because He is present always, no change at all, immutable. Pero ang iya presence will bring changes sa palibot, like the sun. It's there. Pero ang impact niya sa lain-lain nga tao. Kung may disease ang imo mata, pagtanaw mo sa light, sakit. Pero kung normal imo mata, sigahan ka, normal ka. That's why para sa may mga disease sa mata, sobra nga sanag, sakit. Precisely may disease. The same man sa aton soul. Kung sigahan ka sang Dios, daw sakit haw, something is wrong. Pero kunara ka sa grasya, sigahan ka sa Diyos, nag-enjoy ka. Precisely, preparado ka para sa Diyos. So we pray nga mag-increase ang aton remembrance and recognition of God's presence. Tomorrow, hopefully, God's omniscience, His knowledge and wisdom. Amen. All-powerful God, increase our strength of will for doing good, that Christ may find an eager welcome and call us to His side in the kingdom of heaven, where He lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.